Hi, my name is Cindy Farr, and I'm the Incident Commander for the Missoula City County Health Department's COVID-19 response. Today is Tuesday, April 14th, and this is my daily briefing. Our local case counts and numbers today remain the same as they were from yesterday. We've had a total of 32 cases to date in Missoula. 30 of those cases were identified by testing, and 2 were EPI-linked cases, and I talked a little bit about what that means on my briefing from yesterday. We have 24 cases that have recovered and 1 death, which leaves us with 7 active cases. We're currently monitoring 155 close contacts who are all in quarantine at this time. The state of Montana has had a total of 399 cases and 7 deaths. So I want to talk a little bit about how we're reporting our cases. People have been voicing some concern about how we're reporting the numbers, and each person who's reached out has had a different suggestion or a different request for how they think that the numbers should be reported. We know that we can't satisfy everyone's needs, and we really just need to use a standard protocol for reporting cases like all of the other jurisdictions out there. And it's the same as what we have done for every other outbreak that we've faced in Missoula County so far. What I think that people don't realize is that when you go to the state's website, the Johns Hopkins website, or even when you open the newspaper, the number of cases reported is going to be the cumulative number of cases that have occurred. No one is subtracting the number of recovered and the number of deaths to give a net amount of active cases. No one's adjusting the case numbers to include pending tests, and no one has decided that recoveries are not cases at all. There's a standard way of reporting, so when you look at the number of cases that we have here and everywhere else in the world, the number has the same meaning. This way, we know how many cases each area experienced over the cumulative time of the outbreak. So we will be reporting the cumulative number of cases, the number of recoveries, and deaths in the same way as other agencies. What we will do differently is tell you the number of cases that are EPI-linked, which is something that other agencies are not doing. I want to talk a little bit about our drive-through testing clinic at the Missoula County Fairgrounds. Starting today, our testing clinic has expanded its services. So any Missoula County resident or Missoula County healthcare worker who has symptoms of COVID-19, such as cough, fever, or difficulty breathing, may qualify for testing at this time. If you or someone that you are caring for has symptoms, you can call 406-258-INFO. That's 406-258-4636 to speak to a nurse. And if you qualify for testing, you will be connected with someone who can schedule that appointment for you. We've covered why we're concerned about COVID-19 in previous daily briefings, but I think that we need to really talk about some key points again. Since our numbers are low, people may feel that this is no big deal. However, the numbers are small due to the preventative measures that we've put in place, such as social distancing. So I just want to do a little refresher on a few of those key concepts. With COVID-19, our population is naive. It's a novel virus, and having our population naive means that nobody has immunity to it. Everyone can potentially get it and spread it to other people. This is different from other viruses in that there's usually some level of immunity to slow the spread of disease. With COVID-19, there's no vaccine and there's no approved pharmaceutical interventions at this time. So our best tools are human behavior, such as social distancing, hand washing, and staying at home. With COVID-19, many people can get sick. We also know that about 5% of those who get sick develop critical illness, and another 15% develop severe illness. So without slowing the spread, we could really face a spike in cases that could devastate our healthcare resources, meaning that people die because they can't get the medical care that they need because our healthcare infrastructure gets overwhelmed. If you look outside of Missoula County at how this disease has impacted the United States and the world, you start getting an idea of how serious this has been in other areas, and you can see that we can see the potential for having serious cases here in Missoula County and in Montana. In a few short months, almost 2 million people have been diagnosed with COVID-19 around the world. That's twice Montana's population, and globally, over 120,000 people have died, which is more than the population of Missoula County. Here in the United States, over 500,000 people have gotten COVID-19, and about 2.5 months. And last week, over 2,000 people died from COVID-19 complications in one single day. To date, about 22,000 people have died from COVID-19 complications, which is an average of about 260 people each day since the first case in the United States. To give some additional perspective, when we compare this to the 2009 H1N1 pandemic flu, that pandemic flu killed 12,469 people over many, many months. That means that COVID-19 has killed almost twice as many people in a few short months as the entire 2009 H1N1 flu outbreak. While it's too soon to tell if COVID-19 is going to be one of the leading causes of death in 2020, what I can tell you is that it certainly has the potential if it continues to spread in the way that it has been spreading. It's really up to all of us. We don't have a vaccine at this time, and we don't have any other interventions that we can use. So what we have is each other, and it's really important that we just continue to keep that perspective that this does have the potential for being a really big deal, and it really has the potential for killing a lot of people. So we want to do all of those things that we can do to protect each other and really slow the spread of this disease in our Missoula communities. So that's all I have for my daily briefing today. It's a little bit shorter than what it's been in the past. As always, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel at Cindy Farr. That's CindyFarr. Click the little notification bell so that you get notified when another video is uploaded. You can follow us on Facebook at the Missoula City County Health Department. There's lots of great information that gets posted there every day. You can call 258-INFO if you or someone that you are taking care of is having symptoms that are consistent with COVID-19, and they can help you get an appointment scheduled through our drive-through testing clinic. You can also call that 258-INFO line if you just have general questions about COVID-19 or are looking for resources such as rental assistance or assistance in getting food supplies. You can also check our website at missoula.co/cvirus. And as always, thank you for everything that you're doing out there to help us protect our communities, and stay healthy until tomorrow. Thanks.